And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to our Ludum Dare game marathon. Today we are playing Transistor Soup, which is, yeah, something rather different from what we have played so far. It is more a simulation than a game, even though it probably qualifies as a puzzle game. So in this game, you need to design circuit boards of increasing complexity. So let us read the instructions. How to play. Welcome to Transistor Soup. As part of the company's standard training for new hires, you'll be getting acquainted with our proprietary circuit prototyping software through a series of challenging exercises. To create circuits with the software, click and drag parts on the shelf on the right side of the screen, so this one, onto the grid. Drag a part outside of the grid to remove it. Create wires by clicking and dragging anywhere on the grid. Remove wires with right click. So, fairly standard controls. I'm just trying to think. So there's this game, Keep Talking or Otherwise You Will Explode, where you need to defuse some bombs, which also has a part where you need to cut some wires, and yeah, this had similar controls, even though it's a completely different game, but anyway. The parts manual has information on every part available to you. You can open it by clicking the manual button in the corner. If you're unsure what something does, consult the manual. For information on the current puzzle, consult the problem specification. You can open it at any time by clicking the spec button. When you think you've solved the puzzle, click the test button to continue on to the next problem. Good luck and have fun. Swapper. The top output should be the same as the bottom input. The bottom output should be the same as the top input. In other words, the lines are swapped. You might find the bridge part useful for this exercise. Okay. Manual, bridge. Input. The input is used to power the circuit. It can either be on or off. When it's turned on, it transmits power to whatever wire is attached to it. Okay. Output. Okay. The bridge is used to cross wires over each other. Do we really need this bridge? Should be possible to do this without a bridge. Okay. Either on. The output should turn on if either input is on. If both inputs are off, the output should be off. So it's basically an OR gate. Okay. So how do... right click. Okay. Yes. It doesn't automatically remove the whole wire, which I guess... it's a good thing. Depending on what you want to do. Okay, I think you can just do this very easily like this. Okay, that's not the prettiest circuit in the world, but... Okay, this worked apparently, but on the other hand, that wouldn't really work. Well, would it work? Let me. No, it shouldn't work in the real world, since if this is on and this is off, then you would have. Yeah, they cannot be on the same potential. So something unexpected would have to happen. Okay. Anyway, so it worked, and that's, yeah, just a game after all. Both on, the output should turn on only when both inputs are on. So it's, yeah, an AND gate, basically. Inverter, okay. Yeah, so just, okay, we can maybe keep this, so AND is not or, so. So X and Y is the same as not X, sorry, not in brackets, not X or not Y. Okay. So we need some parts. Actually didn't pay attention. Okay. We can use this inverter and insert it here. There. And finally there, okay. Okay, this game doesn't really have anything to do with the theme. Well actually it is explained in the page for this Ludum Dare entry why this actually does fit into the theme A Small World, even though it's a bit of a stretch. Okay, anyway, all on. The output should turn on only when all, okay, so yeah, it's just an AND gate with this times four of those. So basically, yeah, we just have to do that the same thing what we had just again. So if we know how to make an OR gate with several inputs, then we know how to make an OR gate and therefore an AND gate with several inputs. Okay. Pattern matching. Okay, now it's getting a bit more complicated since it's not just basic basic circuits, but some non-basic stuff. Okay, the output should turn on only when the inputs match the pattern as shown in the examples. On, off, on, off. Okay. So only when it matches this pattern. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so we basically, it's an AND. We first of all need an AND gate that combines these with the negation of this one. So basically, if you negate this, then it's just an AND gate. So if we move this one like this, this, the top one and the these two. Oh, sorry. Yeah. Okay. No. Okay. Now. Okay. It must be like this, actually. And then those have to go. This. Is it like this? Let me just check. Yeah, I have a very bad memory, apparently. Yeah, that's correct. Okay. So, oh shit. That's of course not correct. I mean, so basically this, yeah, must be the other way around, actually. Okay. Okay, so we're negating these three. Okay, this should be correct, actually. Yes. So it wasn't too hard. I just, had a hard time actually remembering the pattern. Okay, anyway. Branch inverter. I must say I'm actually having a lot of fun. I don't know what that tells me about. I don't know whether that tells more about the game or more about me anyway. So branch inverter. The top output should be the same as the input. Button, okay, yeah. Quite obvious what we need to do. We need it's basically just, there's hardly a difference between input and output here in this game. I mean, yeah, so just everything reversed. We need to get rid of all this crap here. Okay, this one too. Yeah, let's make this a little bit prettier. Let's make this nice and symmetric. Okay, it won't be very symmetric, but okay, this looks horrible. So the low one is inverted, so it should be like this. Does it work? No, it does not. Wait. Aha. Does it work? Yes. Yeah. So. Basically, we are solving the very same puzzles here that we already solved. The output should okay, now it's getting more interesting. So exactly if one of those, so it's an either or. We have got a new part here. The AND gate, okay. I mean, we've already built AND gates basically, but it's probably will get a bit cumbersome. If we just keep building them basically by hand. So this makes it just more efficient. Okay. Let's get rid of this one. Okay, this we need to know. Okay, okay, we will do that like this. Okay, we have two possibilities here. The first one is this is on and this is off, and so take an inverter. Okay, maybe put it there. Actually, I think I didn't really understand what the AND gate does. The AND gate is used to multiply two signals together. If both inputs are on, the top output will also be on. Okay, so the bottom input is just the opposite of the top one. Okay, yeah, I should have probably noticed earlier that the AND gate actually has one output, I mean two outputs instead of just one, which is a bit strange. Okay, anyway, probably not doing this correct here. Okay, but this will be one solution. Okay, so this is certainly on. If this is on and this is off, that's the only case. Okay, that's one case. The other possibility would be to have this on and the other one off. This should work. Yeah, it's probably not the best solution. Yeah, it's probably not the best. So, I mean, either or is. Okay. Anyways, I mean, it works. That's the. And yeah. So add two. If both inputs are off, both outputs should be off. If both inputs are, if only one input is on, the top output should be on. Okay. Basically just binary addition without, I mean, well, a binary addition without carryover. So in other words, it's just, yeah, modular arithmetic. Okay, I should have probably solved the other exercise using the AND gate properly. Since this is now, yeah, getting more difficult. Okay, binary addition, modular addition. So basically, yeah, modular addition is just the XOR gate. I mean, that's binary multiplication actually. Binary multiplication. Yes. Modular multiplication. But what we need to do is we need to build a modular addition actually. Yeah, so yeah, it's on if both are on and otherwise it's off, and the bottom is the inverse of that signal. And our specification is add two. No, actually it's not. Sorry, we have actually two outputs. It's not it doesn't completely specify it actually does. Yes. No, it actually does not. So the text does not completely specify the output of this of these circuits, but I mean these illustrations they do. So it is after all just modular addition and the lower part is the carryover. If you interpreted this as a just regular addition. Okay, that was took a while. Let us think how you would do that. it probably doesn't help that I'm quite tired, and it is quite late where I am. Maybe I will actually, just do this one more puzzle and then I will stop here. Okay. So let's look at this back again. So basically this basically this is, this is just the end of these two. So we can just very lazily get this going like that. Okay. And the next part is this one, which is basically just what he solved before. It's an either or. So it's Yeah, so okay, maybe let's make it this way. Okay. So this is on if those are different. Yeah, and that's what we want to have. That should work. Yeah, hooray. We've built our very first addition machine with one bit. Okay, now we need to build a circuit where you add three signals together. Which again, the output can be represented of course in only 2 bits, so we have two outputs. But as I already said, I think I will just leave it at that. Yeah, this was Transistor Soup. If you want to check out this game for yourself, there's a link in the description of this video. It's actually This is really fun. And I could myself, it's really something which you can maybe kill some, if you have some 15 minutes or maybe if you have a coffee break and you want to relax, that's a really good game to play, because these puzzles aren't that difficult, but they're still little bit challenging. So I like this actually quite a bit. Until next time, folks. Until then.